policemen arrived and sealed off the area. A crowd gathered, some threw rocks and bottles at police. 4 police cruisers were firebombed. For 9 hours, police watched and waited, occasionally exchanging gunfire with snipers in the building. City officials and black community leaders organized a negotiating committee to try to talk the Black Panthers into giving up.
This is Inspector Cole, Corps 2400.
The negotiators were successful. 10 of the Panthers surrendered. A few minutes later, 3 more came out. Police issued a final warning, then opened up with a tear gas barrage. After 15 minutes, the 3 holdouts, choking and coughing, stumbled out of the building. All 16 have now been charged with murder and conspiracy. This morning, small crowds gathered on the sidewalks in front of the Panther headquarters to discuss the night of gunfire. The blood-splattered car marking the spot where Officer Smith was killed was still there. Homicide detectives arrived to reconstruct the incident. The spent tear gas canisters, the sandbagged windows, and bullet holes were everywhere. And the detectives found a rifle and ammunition still in the house. It was one they had missed.
Black Panther's headquarters.
Right across the street from where my father's restaurant is. With all them people over there.
What was the name of your father's restaurant?
Borm's Soul Food.
Ooh, wow.
He had 2. With the one was on Mac and the other one's right there on Jefferson, right across from Unroy.
And how was it during the 67 riots?
Miss.
Talk to her. I was a baby.
You said you was only 3.
I was only 3 and a half.
And you was 12.
About 12, yeah.
So what was the atmosphere like?
I was 13.
So you had a curfew. You had to go in.
I'd be on that front porch before the street lights came on.
So did y'all go to school at that time, during them times, or how was it?
Well, when the riot broke out?
Uh-huh.
It just happened when that riot broke out.
It lasted how long?
Since it was during the summertime, we was out of school for the summer.
Oh, okay.
We was out of school for the summer. I was at my father's restaurant when it broke out.
Uh-huh.
And it started over there on 12th Street.
Yeah. Oh, which is Rosa Parks Boulevard now.
It started over there on the west side and came clean to the east side.
Mm.
And they tore up 12th Street and back.
Mm-hmm.
Threw all that up and routed, looted everything but the kitchen sink.
Mm.
And when they broke out that riot, by the time my father got up, got to me and my brother, he called. He like, I'm on my way. Shut it down.
Right.
I locked up to the front door. The Black Panthers stood in front and said, can't nobody come in or the people is in coming out.
Dig that. The Black Panthers in Detroit City had a headquarters.
Yeah, man, that headquarters down there on Mac.
Wow.
That's how I met. I was young, but I remember Angela Davis. You know, Angela Davis, her being a part of that.
Mm-hmm.
I met a lot of them folks down there.
See, that's how we learn our history when we open up and start asking. Because nobody's not going to tell our history like we are.
Nope.
Right.
Because they don't tell us this in school or in our textbooks.
And they was making people get off, shut their businesses down, get off the street. And my father and mother had to shut our store and the restaurant on Jefferson down.
So they didn't bother your family store?
No.
Restaurant?
Or the restaurant. They didn't bother that. They told me y'all crazy. If people in that area, like on Mac, I had the Black Panthers, you know, helping us out. They let nobody, y'all can hit everything y'all want, but leave these folks alone.
Wow, that's deep.
Jefferson, police had that covered too. I don't care what you do, don't bother these people.
See, you know, back then it was like, this was my whole world.
Right.
This part, these projects, it was my whole world. I didn't know nothing else outside of this.
Right, see.
You know, coming up as a little kid.
Right.
So we didn't, like riots or whatever, we didn't taste none of that in here.
Right.
We didn't know what was going on. We just kids having fun.
Right. I didn't even know we were poor.
That's right. You know, I knew I was poor.
We had all the necessities that we needed here in Parkside. Like the suburbs.
And everything was free. We had summer camp.
Yeah.
We had summer camps. We went to Edgewater Park.
That's
Cedar
right.
Point,
Cedar Point.
All on the city.
That's right.
I didn't know where the world would be poor either. I had to taste all that. Cedar Point, Edgewater Park, Bobo.
Right.
And by the time I got 12, 13, I was taking all my younger brothers and nieces and nephews to all that stuff.
Right. I didn't know we were poor until someone mentioned to me that we were poor.
I didn't know we were poor until we started going to the schools outside.
Oh, yeah.
And we said, oh, wait a minute.
And somebody like y'all know, somebody like, y'all poor like me. Now, nigga, you poor. I ain't poor.
Right.
As long as I got shoes on my feet and a roof over my head, I ain't poor.
Participated in everything.
Yeah, we did too.
All right. Well, thank you.
No problem.